Districts across the state are seeing enrollment drop, but Houston County school numbers are actually moving in the opposite direction. Our morning reporter Pepper Baker joins us live with more on how the district is managing its growing student population ahead of the governor's budget cuts. Good morning, Pepper.
Good morning, Aaron. That's right. Houston schools have actually seen an average increase of about 350 students per year for the last decade. And of course, more students means more state funding. But with Governor Brian Kemp's statewide cutbacks, Superintendent Mark Scott explains how that factors into their budget and whether it affects students.
So it's very important that we get accurate counts, in October and March of each year so that we are receiving the funds that we're entitled to from the state.
Houston County Superintendent Mark Scott says he aims to make decisions around the governor's budget cuts that will affect their students, staff, and taxpayers the least.
Our FY20 budget was approximately $295 million, and about $200 million of that money came from the state, and the governor has instructed us to prepare for a 14% cut in those revenues.
That would mean a $28 million cut, but later Scott got word that Kemp wants to trim an 11% cut, meaning Houston would lose $22 million instead.
There's not many times when you say you're thankful for 11% cut, but we certainly are thankful to have 11% versus 14 because that's a $6 million swing for us.
Scott is working with the board on a tentative budget plan that doesn't include raising millage rates, furloughing employees, or shortening the school year.
Typically, in a budget, we're replacing equipment and vehicles and buses and some of those kinds of things. And all those capital purchases, we will not do. Those large purchases, we will cut back on that.
He says the school board's worked hard to save for a rainy day and can use some of the $44 million in their fund balance to get through the state's economic setback.
I think this is a great opportunity for us to take care of the school district, but at the same time, be respectful of taxpayers and the difficult time that they're going through. So there is no consideration for increasing taxes with regard to our millage rate or increasing our millage rate.
Now, 6 years ago, Scott says their fund balance was at about $20 million and now has grown to $44 million since then. Reporting live from home, Pepper Baker, 13 WMAZ News.
Thank you, Pepper. The board discussed their tentative budget at yesterday's meeting and will decide on a final plan during their July 21st meeting.